سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فهو المهتد ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه وخليله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة فتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها ما زاغ عنها إلا هالك وما استمسك بها إلا مهتد صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين وبعد. One of the main causes for failure is foreseeing failure or forecasting failure or predicting failure before it even happens. Meaning that we determine that the outcome of any idea, any project, any aspiration we have in life as doomed to fail, and we consider that to be the natural outcome. Once we come to that conclusion, once we make that judgment that anything that we want to accomplish in this life is doomed to fail, then definitely the outcome is going to be what? Failure. Why? For a very simple reason. If a person believes that something is not going to work, then they're not going to try it, right? So there will be no efforts made here. Why would I exert any efforts if I believe they're worthless? If I believe that nothing is going to materialize out of them, nothing is going to happen. So, what caused failure here? What caused our failure is our inaction. And this is something that the Almighty Allah forbids in the Quran. This is something that our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam forbids. This is something that Islam forbids. In fact, this is something that contradicts our own instinct as human beings. Because people have that instinct in them that they are always aspiring. They always want to change a situation. We're not static. Look at yourself. Look at any human being. We're talking about average, normal human beings. They're active, right? There's a reason why people wake up early, go to work. There's a reason why kids go to school. There's a reason why we move. There is motion in this life. Because that's how you earn your living, that's how you give your life a meaning. Animals do the same. That's what life is about. Allah Azza wa Jalla tells us in the Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الرَّسُولُ بَلِّغْ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مَا أُنزِلَ إِلَيْكَ مِنْ رَبِّكَ وَإِنْ لَمْ تَفْعَلْ فَمَا بَلَّغْتَ رِسَالَتَهُ. O Messenger, proclaim or deliver the message that was revealed to you by your Lord. And if you don't, then you have not delivered his message. Meaning that every single prophet was given a mandate, and that mandate is to do their part, is to act, is to proclaim, to do their best, not to guarantee the outcome. The outcome or forecasting the outcome was not within their mandate. So some prophets, some messengers were very successful in terms of the outcome. Some others weren't that much successful in terms of the outcome, but doesn't mean that they have failed. You want an example? Take the example of Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam. How many believed in him after 950 60 years of his da'wah. How many believed in Noah? وَمَا آمَنَ مَعَهُ إِلَّا قَلِيرٌ, right? That's what Allah told us, that very few believed in Noah. But how did Allah grant Noah alayhi salam? He made him the first to be mentioned among the five of Ulul Azm, the most resilient. Because the thrust of his responsibility, the thrust of any messenger's responsibility, the thrust of any human being's responsibility is what? Do your part. Right? Make the efforts. بلغ إنما عليك البلاغ. Communicate. Do your part. And leave the rest with Allah Azza wa Jal. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us in a hadith, من قال هلك الناس فهو أهلكهم أو أهلكهم. We have two narrations. If a person say people have perished, then it is him who caused them to perish, or he is the first one to perish amongst them. Why? Because he had predicted, he had forecasted failure before it even happened. He had forecasted destruction before destruction was inflicted on people. So he made that judgment. And because of that judgment that he made, he did not act to try to prevent it and to avoid it. Had he acted, then he could have had a different outcome. So it's again about what? It's about our action. Every one of us knows the story of this man who came to the masjid of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he had a camel with him, right? So he came to the Prophet now, and he looks at the Prophet and he asks a silly question. He says, O Prophet of Allah, should I tie this camel when I go to pray? Now I'm coming to, I want to go in to pray. Should I tie the camel or should I leave it untied? Since I'm coming to the Masjid of Allah, then Allah should protect my camel here. It shouldn't go astray because I'm in the Masjid of Allah. What was the answer of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Did he tell him, trust Allah and go pray and leave your camel untied? No. He told him what? اعقلها وتوكل. Tie it, do your part, then place your trust in Allah. You do your part, you do what you're supposed to do, then you place your trust in Allah Azza wa Jal. Everyone knows this story, right? How is it being translated, manifested in our lives, in our experiences? In the Quran, we also find that Allah Azza wa Jal has entrusted us with a mission. This mission is called Imaratul Ard, Al-Istikhlaf. Al-Istikhlaf, the enablement, the inheritance, the leadership role in this land. According to our scholars, or some of our scholars, they call it Imaratul Ard, constructing the land. Allah Azza wa Jalla says, إِنَّا عَرَضْنَا الْأَمَانَةَ عَلَى السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَالْجِبَالِ فَأَبَيْنَ أَنْ يَحْمِلْنَهَا وَحَمَلَهَا الْإِنسَانُ إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا. So the trust was offered to the heavens, to the earth, to the mountains, and they refused to take it. They were scared thereof, of the weight of this amana, of this trust. But man took it. And then Allah tells us that man is oppressor, is oppressor and is ignorant. You want a manifestation, you want an evident, a substantiation of this accusation? Just look around you. Who shaken the balance of this universe? It is man. Who is destroying earth? It is man. Who is polluting water? It is man. Who is polluting the atmosphere? It is man. Who is killing animals to the point of extinction? It is man. We were given this trust, and many of us did not understand the thrust of the trust. So yes, they are engaged in action, but it is a destructive action. There is a reason why we're suffering from COVID-19. Yes, well, regardless of where it came from, regardless of the nature of the virus, but we know that there was a total failure in trying to contain this virus. Just take the example of this country here. Take the denial of the previous administration of the pandemic. Take the lies. Because the previous president, the former president Trump, was worried that it will impede his chances of winning a second term. We know these as facts today because they are well documented. إِنَّهُ كَانَ ظَلُومًا جَهُولًا. That man, when man is not engaged in action or engaged in the wrong actions, you will end up with what? With what you see today. So failure, when we forecast it, it is going to be the inevitable outcome because we are in a state of inaction. And if we act in a bad manner, also we are ensuring destruction. That's why we say manat al-takleefi huwa al-amal. In Islam, the thrust of our responsibility is what? Is action. But not any action, a guided action. Always, if you read the Quran, you will always find that عمل الصالحات is connected to what associated with us. آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات. You have to have that belief, that guidance, and the outcome will be righteousness and righteous work. When Allah referred to us as the best of people of all for mankind, it was based on a criteria. But even Allah, before Allah mentioned iman in him, he said, يؤمن تؤمنون بالله وتأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله. That you enjoy what is right, forbid what is wrong, and you believe in Allah. Because doing what is right, forbidding what is wrong, will lead to a true belief or substantiate the true belief in Allah. So my dear brothers and sisters, let's keep this in mind, that it is all about our actions and what kind of actions we take. They should be guided and they should be to serve the collective good and never forecast failure. Never give up on something before you try your best. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم فاستغفروه. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. I will start by asking everyone here to do one thing since we're talking about action. Am I going to look at anyone? So I'm going to look up to the roof or to the ceiling and say, please, if you're not covered, if your nose is not covered, cover it, please. That's the first line of action that we need to do. Let me tell you one. In order to keep this masjid open, we have to have zero cases here. If anyone gets COVID here, you're not going to come and enjoy Ramadan. So that's the first line of action. Let us make sure that we do our best. Keep your mask in the masjid. Keep your nose covered as well as your mouth. You might think that I don't have COVID, 99.99% inshallah, none of us has it. It doesn't mean that something might not happen. So we need to be very careful. My dear brothers and sisters, since we're talking about Ramadan, I want to remind you that Ramadan is in less than 2 weeks from now. When one of the months of Ramadan was approaching during the lifetime of our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, He addressed his companion saying, أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ قَدْ جَاءَكُمْ شَهْرٌ عَظِيمٌ شَهْرٌ مُبَارَكٌ. O people, a great month is coming to you, a blessed month. A month in which Allah Azza wa Jal has obligated you to fast its days. And a month when it comes, the gates of mercy are open and the gates of hellfire are closed and the devils are chained. A month in which there is one night that is better than 1,000 months. Whoever gets deprived of its advantages, he will be deprived. And that is the night of Al-Qadr, the night of power. We are fast approaching this month. Inshallah, we ask the Almighty to make us among those who are blessed to make it to the month of Ramadan and to live through the month of Ramadan and to be among the forgiven in the month of Ramadan. As the hadith tells us that Allah sends in every night during the night of Ramadan, and that's in every night, not on the 27th or the 25th or the last night, it's in every night. An angel who's calling on us, Ya Baghi al-Khayr Aqbil, Wa Ya Baghi al-Sharri Adbir. O seeker of goodness, come forward and fulfill that intention. And O seeker of evil, desist and don't do whatever Satan is whispering to you. And Allah has so many to be freed from the hellfire, and that is in every single night in Ramadan, according to the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ. So we're fast approaching that month. Let us, inshallah, prepare from now. Let us hope that we get to the month of Ramadan safe, and our family safe, inshallah. And let us plan to do our parts in it. One of it, make sure you abide by this. I'm giving the khutbah, so there is this glass before me. Once I finish the prayer, I'll put it back like everyone else. The second thing, the Masjid inshallah Rabbil Alameen has, as every year, alhamdulillah, we're reopening the Iftar al-Sa'im program, inshallah, to help those who are in need to break their fast. And by helping those who are in need, the fasting people, to break their fast, you're getting the same reward they're getting without taking away anything from their reward. So you're sharing with the reward without reducing their reward, and they don't reduce their reward. So it's $195 to cover one fasting person to break his fast during the month of Ramadan, $195. So if you want to pledge something, if you want to give, if you want to donate, if you want to do the right thing and to base your iman on action and you can afford it, maybe you can't afford $195, do whatever you can. Just go to the, inshallah, to the office, or we have the boxes, and give something, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, so that Allah, bi'idhnillah, will judge us based on our good actions, and we will have an abundant good action to meet him in the day of judgment, inshallah. Allahumma ighfir lana wa lil muslimina ajma'in. Allahumma waj'alna mimman yasiluna ramadan wa mimman yasumuna ramadan wa mimman taghfir lahum fi ramadan wa mimman taqbaluhum fi ramadan. Allahumma sallimna min hadha al waba warfa'hu 'anna ajma'in. اللهم وأبرم لهذه الأمة أمر رشد يعز فيه أولياؤك وتعلو فيه رايتك ويهزم فيه أهل معصيتك وأنت يا خير من الصلاة.